Hey, how we doing? So today we're getting some tie plates on the bridge. So we have the placing for the rails going across. Essentially, we have the switch over there and the bridge here. We have a pretty simple layout, but this portion is probably the most complicated. And so that's why we're starting right here. But here we go on the tie plates. First of all, we use some 1x right here. Maybe if you're doing this, you do it a little bit wider, but it looks great. I think it's gonna work out. But what we ended up doing is using some of these Accu-Tie tie plates. It just felt better than going right into the wood with the screw. So we grabbed these, but they got a little bit wide. And if you can see, if you put the screw on either end, it would almost be hanging over the edge. So it didn't make sense. So we wanted to get it centered. And then instead of, I don't know, that would have looked funny with these tie plates hanging off the side. So we cut them in half. I basically made a little jig and cut them right down the middle on the saw. And there we have it. Now we have all these guys cut in half. If you're gonna use these, once again, they're cool. Remember that canter that they slant in, and you got the arrow that tells you to, you know, put it towards the center when you're using these with your rail. The 5/16 base, and that's essentially the base of the rail on both this Midwest scale rail, 141 pound rail, and then also West Coast rail that, you know, Accu-Tie uses. And I'll show you in another video, but they'll butt up together just fine as far as the rail goes. But I don't know, these ties might be useful to you if you're not going to use Accu-Tie's tie, for example, and you're going to use some other material like plastic, wood, and all that. These might be something you're looking for. Easy decision for us because we have a small layout, but if you're going to have miles and miles of track, maybe that's a different kind of decision for you. So that's what we're doing right now, though, is getting the tie plates on the bridge. And to get started, I fastened up an Accu-Tie tie. I tend to use these a lot for gauge bars. So I put one on this end to get the rail together, put one down there on that end, get the rail together, got the rail put in place, and then did two there, and then we started to do every other one. Which leaves us about, what is that, maybe 5 1/4 on center. And I did that just in case I had to switch it around and made an error, or maybe over time it's something that I have to redo, is either put more in or flip-flop them, or one fails on me and I'll need to maybe double up on each side. We'll see how it goes over time. Lots of videos to come even after we're up and running on maintenance, and you know, how things are going, and maybe some recommendations for you in the future if you don't already have yours set up someday. So I basically just gotta finish down to that end. I did start on both ends. I meant to start on one end and work my way down, but the rail's rigid enough that I was able to get a start on that end too, and that really just solidified everything. And now I'm heading that way for whatever reason. And then one last thing, I'll be able to loosen up just a little bit on the screws so this rail will slide back and forth when I make the connection to the switch over there. We'll see how we get that going. And because of the height too, we gotta make sure we get the height right. Did you feel? Hon kommer från främmande vidder, där havet är land och land hav, där vindarna brusar och forsarna susar och skatorna ger sig av. Hon är eldfast och stark, hon är sårbar och öm. Hon kommer från främmande vidder, hon stannar hos dig som en dröm. Hon vänder sig om när du vunnit och solar i glansen. Hon äger styrkan du alltid trodde var din. När tystnaden dånar som oljud,
stroma che alza. När infrosten glittrar, då står hon i dörren på vilén. Hon kommer från främmande vidder, där stormen är lä och lä storm. Där är svart och vitt, och där är mitt i det.